In this illustration, we'll discuss and analyze a particle falling on a pan. Here the figure shows a pan of mass 2m attached to a vertical spring of force constant k in equilibrium. And a small body of mass m falls on pan from a height 2mg/k and stick to it. We are able to find the time from release of m to the moment when the spring has maximum compression. Here we can see initially the spring will be having some compression. So here we can write initial compression and a spring. This can be written as x naught, which we can write as due to the weight of the span, its downward force is 2mg and upward is kx naught. So it is 2mg/k. That is the initial compression in the spring. When a small m also falls on it, the new equilibrium position will be at 3mg/k. So we can write after m falls, further compression to equilibrium position and a spring is, this can be written as x naught dash, which is mg/k, that is the further compression due to the weight of this mass m. So here we can redraw the situation when the ball falls onto it. Here we can see this would be the new equilibrium position, which is at a distance of x naught dash, and the total mass is m plus 2m, 3m, which is going down. And we can calculate the speed with which the combined mass is going down by conservation of momentum. So here we can write collision speed of mass is, this we can write as root 2gh. And here we use, if the combined speed is v1 after collision, as m had an inelastic collision with this mass 2m, so we can write mv is equals to 3mv1, where we get the value of v1, the speed with which the combined mass with pan is moving, that is 1/3 times root 2gh. Now the system will be oscillating in the influence of the spring. And from this as equilibrium position, we can say at a distance x naught dash, the system is moving at a speed v1. So we can easily calculate the amplitude of oscillation. So if A be the oscillation amplitude of m plus 2m, here we can write this is speed v1. Which is 1/3 times root 2gh should be equals to the angular speed of oscillation for this spring. We can write as root of m/k. So it is root of k/3m. So in this situation here we can write the value of k is root of k/3m multiplied by a square minus the distance is x naught dash square. So I'm using the relation of velocity of SHM of an oscillating body. So here squaring this, we are getting 2gh/9 is equals to k/3m a square minus mg/k whole square. Now in this situation, we can solve and get the value of amplitude here. This 3 gets cancelled out, and on simplifying, I'll get the value of A as root of 7/3 times mg/k. So this is what we are going to get. And in this situation, you can also substitute the value of H as 2mg/k, which is given over here. So this is the amplitude with which the combined mass would be oscillating. And here to find out the time it will take to reach the extreme position in oscillation, we can map it on circular motion. Here you can map it on circular motion, where the amplitude of oscillation is A, and body is starting at a distance x prime, x naught prime from the mean position and going down. So this is the reference particle which is coming down, and we are required to find the time it reaches the extreme bottom position. So we can say the change in phase required to reach this position is theta, and the value of theta we can write as pi by 2 plus sine inverse of this will be x naught dash by a. On substituting the value of x naught dash as mg by k and a as root 7 by 3 mg by k, we are getting it pi by 2 plus sine inverse of root of 3 by 7. So this is the phase change in going from this position to the bottom extreme position. And we can also calculate the time the mass will take in falling down by a distance h. So here total time we can calculate as root 2 h by g, the time the mass will take in falling under gravity in free fall motion, plus this angle theta by omega, the angular frequency of this oscillation if we substitute. On substituting the value of h as 2 mg by k, here this will give us 2 root m by k, plus the value of theta we are having, and the value of omega is root of k by 3m. So it is root of 3m by k multiplied by the angle, which is pi by 2 plus sine inverse of root of 3 by 7. So this is the final result of this problem. The total time starting from the fall of m to the time when the whole combined system reaches its bottom extreme point.